Assalamu alaikum. I'm Ameer Muhammad, senior subject specialist at Government High Secondary School, Tavdijana, Deer Lower. Today we will discuss direct and indirect. Direct and indirect narration. Actually, we have to make it clear what is direct narration and what is indirect narration. Direct narration is the quotation, the exact words of a person which are enclosed in several inverted commas. And when we talk about indirect narration, that is a change abroad in the exact words which were spoken in the direct narration. So, change brought in the direct narration. So, we have to be careful whenever this change is brought. This is a brought due to the rules. If the rules are not studied, if you are, if a person is not clear in the rules, then it will be very much difficult for him to understand the change which is usually brought in them. Before going to the detail, we should clarify two important key elements, key parts of the direct and indirect narration. She said, I am busy. So, the part of the direct narration which is not enclosed in the double inverted quotes, that is known as a reporting speech. And the part which is enclosed in the double inverted commas, that is known is the reported speech. So, in the word of the reporting speech is known as iska reporting word. And the word, the principal word, the auxiliary word, the lexical word, that is the reporting word. In the rules ahead, we repeat reporting speech, reported word, etc., etc., etc. For our convenience, we divide the direct and indirect narration into different categories. The first one is assertive narration. Assertive narration. In assertive narration, either a people have affirmative or declarative or negative sentences. So, assertive narration is comprised of affirmative and negative sentences. The second one is interrogative narration. It is very much there whenever question mark is there at the end of the sentence, other than the period or full stop, we call it interrogative narration. Then the third one category in which we have defined the direct and indirect narration, that is imperative narration. In imperative narration, it seems from the title that it has any command. The sentences, these sentences usually when we discuss sentences, they don't have any subject. They start by, they commence by first form of the verb. For example, go, go, stuff, then it's infected. Number four, optative direction. Optative direction, usually we pray or we suppose an idea which is possible or not possible in the form of good that you were the king, being you lived long, etc., etc. So, optative narration. The fifth one is experimental narration. In experimental narration, certain feelings are found, and usually, exclamation mark is here as well, and exclamation mark is here as well. Now we come towards the rules. Step by step, we'll go ahead just to create this nut of direct and indirect narration. What is all the story about? So, the first one we take assertive narration. Assertive narration. And rules. Rule number one. When the reporting verb is in present or future tense, then the verb of reported speech remains in the sentence. We have to be very much clear, very much sensitive to futures. Same tense means if it is in past indefinite, it should remain in past indefinite. If it is in present indefinite, it should remain in present indefinite, etc. For example, you will say to her, I am busy. You will say to her, or you will tell her that you are busy. Same tense, same idea, is an R belong to sentence. Second example, she says to me, he works hard. She tells me that he works hard. This example is very much typical. Typical in a sense that one person, one student can feel that he works hard. No change in the tense, in the structure, in the arrangement of the words. Second rule, when the reporting speech is in past tense, then the reporting verb is changed into its respective one. This is very much important. If a student learns about this second rule, it will be very much easy for him to go through the whole story, the whole drama, the whole chemistry of the direct and indirect narration. I'm giving you here a simple example. You say to me, she has won the match. Then she had won the match. Say past tense. This quotation, this insertion, in double quotes, present perfect tense is changed into past perfect tense. This is simple single example. I would like to repeat it like this one. Whenever we do have here present indefinite tense. Present indefinite, I'm not quite tense over here. Indefinite past perfect. Present continuous. Past continuous. Present perfect. Past perfect. Present perfect. Continuous. Past perfect continuous tense. This present perfect, this is present perfect. It is changed into past perfect. If it is present perfect, so then past perfect, if it is in present continuous, then past continuous, if it is in present perfect continuous, then it will be changed into past perfect continuous. We are coming towards the more tenses. Past indefinite, past perfect. Past continuous. Past perfect continuous. Practice is very much needed for learning all these rules. I rub that area in the next area will be shifted to the English one, to his own mind. So now, towards the next area, after past continuous return comes off past perfect. It will remain the same, mean same as past perfect. And then past perfect continuous will remain the same. Means there will be no change. If it is in past perfect and past perfect continuous, nothing will happen. Now we are moving towards the rules. Any universal truth takes the present form. Are the exact words in tense expressed in the statement. Will not move, will not touch, will not disturb. The structure, the arrangement, the syntax of the words. For example, the teacher said, honesty is the best policy. So please, the teacher said that honesty is the best policy. Which if I repeat the Brahma in the middle of my lecture, Bhati in the beginning of my lecture, the double quotes are usually changed by the word yet. We move, we up in our next other videos, inshallah, we discuss the parts of speech, the word of the convention, this junk, etc. We move on towards that one. But here, we have to keep only one thing in our mind, that double quotes are shifted, removed, taken place by the word that. Now the fourth one, rule is, the first person pronoun. The first person pronoun. These are personal pronouns. I, me, my, our, us, mine, etc. Of the reported speech. Changes because of the single pronoun. Changes according to subject of the reporting speech. Example, she said to her, I were on. One thing we have to keep in our minds, that these rules are attached together, like a chain. So one rule will be interested somewhere and other rule will be there. And so I want to say a rule should be kept in mind and there should be no negligence. So now we have to understand, this is my reporting speech. This is my first person pronoun. This is my subject of reporting speech. This is object of my reporting speech. So this first person pronoun will change according to the subject of the reporting speech. So she told her that he had worked hard. Simple. Past indefinite into past perfect. Past indefinite into past perfect. In first person according to the subject of the reporting speech. The next rule is second person pronoun. The second person pronoun will be usual of the reported speech changes according to the object of reporting speech. Example, you said to him, you will be late. You told him that he would be late. This is my second person pronoun. This is object, and the change is for this person pronoun, the objective case, and he will come over here. Now, rule number 6. In the rule number 6, the third person pronoun will be this. How the third person pronoun is changed in accordance to which area of the reporting speech. the third person pronoun, these are first person pronouns. He, she, it, they, their, them, etc. Of the reported speech. Will be changed according to nothing. They will remain the same. The same means if their she is used, so then she will remain she. If he, so then he will remain he. For example, you say to me, she learns a lot. You told me that she learns a lot. Present is written to past continuous. So these are principles which are in the people. But the practice is very much important if a student wants to learn effectively and show her excellence over the command, over the direct reading, the narration, then rules are very much necessary and important. I want to keep it too long. The last rule of this is the utmost important, like the second rule of direct and indirect narration. Is the second rule is the key rule of the certificate category. Just like this, this rule is very much important. Rule number 7. Few words are changed respectively. Is a man are changed into was. Was, were, changed into had been. His hair is changed into had. Do, does, changed into had. This into that. Here into here. So into thus, come into go, may into might, shall or will into what, can into put, today then. Yesterday, the previous day, tomorrow, the next day, night, that day. In one thing we have to keep in our mind, whenever ingredients are there, good morning, good evening, good noon, good night, they are simply changed into ingredients. So, up till now, we have discussed the assertive category in detail with the rules. Single rule requires at least 50-30 sentences, example, to be examined by a teacher, to be examined by an expert. Expert of the arena means to be the teacher. The second category is interrogative,
narration.
So, in interrogative narration, simple rules are involved, simple discussion is there. We will not make lengthy our lecture, we will simply make it lucrative, fruitful, and very useful. Interrogative narration. Rules. Rule number one. The reporting word is changed into ask, are, are. Now, don't put your heads into ask and is inquired. Simply, we will say they are synonymous. Synonymous means one is informal and the other is formal. So, the reporting word is changed to ask, are, and inquired. Number the second rule, that is not mentioned. Next, third one. Question mark is removed, is not used. Number fourth one, fourth and fifth rules are very important to be understood. When the reported speech starts by WH kind of words, then they are mostly left the same without any addition. Addition of any word, addition of any indicator, etc. Number fifth one, when the reported speech starts by any helping word, HB helping word, sorry. For example, hates, hate, is, will, do, did, etc. We, it, if or whether in the narration. Just after the reporting speech. Rules are finished after interrogative narration. Now, I have two examples, and the two examples will be here, these five rules. For example, she said to me, word is your name. Look at the structure. The structure is very much simple. A in top of the sentence with the question mark at the end. Includes the relevant word from asking. She asked, I inquired, if you want a me, it's okay, otherwise you can ignore it. She asked, I inquired, me, what was, not two seconds, in according to this. What was my name? As we have discussed, that rules, especially the accepted category rules, they are used everywhere and they cannot be ignored. Second example, you said me, can I help you? You help me. Now, if you look at these presenters, according to first rule, the reporting work is changing to ask by the same date is not that is wrong. Question mark is removed, question mark is removed. Now, what you may ask is what? No addition. And here, like this, the helping verb is there. Then, if after that, we eat in the narration, which means in the indirect narration. Now, this is first person pronoun. And first person pronoun, since it's a correct question, now this you. And this is my second person pronoun. The second person pronoun, since it's a correct question. Object of the reporting speech. So this me. So this rule is method rule that it is repeated over there. This is the honest rule about the interrogative narration. Now we move towards the imperative narration. The third category, which is of equal importance and cannot be ignored, especially for the students, because whenever you look at any narration, the idea should come to your mind to which category my narration, this narration, belongs. The third category, the imperative narration. Rules. Is the term imperative shows that there should be some command, suggestion, etc. We simply write over here, reporting verb is changed into order suggested. Forbade, commanded, proposed, etc. These are them. Now, another important aspect is there of the imperative category. When do not is used in the reported speech, then the reporting verb is changed into forbade. In do not is ignored or not when let in the narration is for proposal. Then the reporting word is changed into proposed and should is added in the indirect action. Number fourth rule, when let in the narration is for request, then soon after reporting speech to allow R to protect is Now please look at the examples. Examples of this category, because we have finished the rules of this category as well. The master said to his servant, bring my shoes. The master ordered his servant to bring. Now this is the first person, master, his shoes. Next example, the teacher said to his students, do not talk. The teacher told his teacher are they his students to talk. Forbid is incorporated, and when forbid is incorporated, the do not is taken out of the narration. The next one, they say, let us go for a walk. Now, they propose that they should go further. Next, the girl said to them, let me go home. The girl requested them to allow her to go home. So this is the indirect category. In indirect category, simple rules are involved and simple changes are required. The key point is the main area is the control constraint, the arranging the bends, etc., the changes required in a narration. So after that, Optative category is also very simple. Few rules are there, and we have to take care of those few rules. Once we understood those rules, nothing is left in the area, the relation category will be on the fingertips of us. Rules. Reporting word is changed into prayer if reported speech is commenced by word like me. Reporting word is changed into wishing if
In one more explanation, mark is removed. For example, she said to him, "May you live now." Explanation. She prayed him that he might live. This is going to be just again and again in the second person, how long I used to change the title of the law, how to go for the speech, because once we have a bigger period, this is going to be kept with our hands. You said to me the word that I was the king. You wished that you can be the king. And if you want any third or fourth rule, so that date is almost used in these narrations. So we can take the date can be used in the narration. The last category is of exclamatory category. Exclamatory category. In exclamatory category, exclamation is there, surprise is there, the wonder is there, a person feels happy, God forbid, saved, etc. But the feelings are shown. Number 10, exclamatory category. Rules. Reporting. Word. Is changed into exclaim with joy. If in the reported speech, word or words like hurrah, second rule, reporting, work is changed into explain with sorrow. If alas, like words are there in the reported speech. And the third one, almost the last one, because only the text who will be there, the text is almost used, but it's okay. We cannot mention that. That's not reported. That's part of changing. Reporting. Work is changed. Explain with wonder if wow, etc. words are there in the reporting speech. Examples. She said, "Hurrah, I have won names are named. She explained with joy that she had won. Yeah, one thing is, one thing has to be noted. That hurrah, words like hurrah, alas, etc. are usually ignored. They are not accepted. You said, alas, I am a man. You say, with sorrow, that you were she said what happened to her. Come with this. She explained with wonder that it was a very beautiful car. With this statement, in sentence like anything that they should in that intended category, with that left. So these are the story about the narration, indirect narration, the rules, etc., etc. I'm a student of English literature. I want to learn, I want to improve as well. And I want to give something to my students, whether they are in my class or they are out of the way. Thank you so much.